يا أيها الذين آمنوا كتب عليكم الصيام كما كتب على الذين من قبلكم لعلكم تتقون.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. رمضان tip 2, moderation and consistency. How many of us come into Ramadan and we are pumped, we are excited, we are ready to go, we are energized, and by the day we come to day 5, all that energy is gone, it is finished, and we go back to our normal ways. I want to give you an example, my dear brothers and sisters. If I was to hand you a brand new car, a car that has never ever been driven before, a car worth hundreds of thousands, if not millions of dollars, and I say to you, this car is going to be your car free of charge, but you have to take care of it, because this is the only car I'm going to give you. So then you take this key, you start the car, and you sit there for a very long time, knowing that you have to warm up the engine before you can really, really get in there and give it all you got. Because if you were to put the pedal to the metal and straight away give this car and push this car to its limits, there's a possibility, being that it is new, that it is possibility that you can blow the motor or something can go wrong. Likewise, a person who runs in track and field, a person who runs long distances, knows that he has to try to preserve his stamina right until the middle or to the end of the race. Because if he was to sprint very early on, there's a big possibility that he would not finish the race. Likewise, my dear brothers and sisters, this should be the same way that we should approach Ramadan. We should approach Ramadan at an easy, steady pace. We should be consistent in our actions, in our ibadah, whatever it is we want to do. And yes, 100% right, Ramadan is the best of months. Ramadan is the month that we should be trying to do more, and we should do more, but we should do it at a consistent rate. We don't want to be like those people who unfortunately do start off very hard and very strong in Ramadan, yet they do not finish. So my dear brothers, let us follow the sunnah and the advice of the Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he said, as narrated by Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu, that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, take up good deeds only as much as you are able. For the best deeds are those who are done consistently, even if they are few. So here we learn from the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the one who had the best foresight, the one who had the best of speech. He's telling us here that a constant deed, even though it is small, it is loved by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and it is better than a deed which is big, which is massive, which is done, and then is never ever done again. So we have to try our best, my dear brothers and sisters, to follow the advice of our Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in this blessed month. Choose some actions that you did not do outside Ramadan, actions that are realistic, goals that you can reach this month. We want to aim for the sky. That is right. We want to do this best this Ramadan because we want to take advantage that the gates of paradise are open and the gates of the hellfire are closed. We want to take advantage of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's mercy. And we want to do the best we can to earn this mercy and to come out of Ramadan with our sins forgiven and our grade of taqwa higher than what it was previously to Ramadan. But this should be done in a constant, moderate way in order for us not to burn out, in order for us to take the advantage of Ramadan in all of its days and all of its nights. Let us not be like those, and let us not be like maybe ourselves in the past who have come into Ramadan very strong and then have washed away or withered away throughout the middle of the month, and then you find the people returning in the last days. And then after that obviously follows the regret of not doing enough. So my dear brothers and sisters, be moderate, be constant, and let us get the most out of this Ramadan. Barakallahu feekum. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.